Welcome to Old Oak Common, the site of HS2's new superhub station in West London. Old Oak Common is one of four stations we're building for the HS2 line between London and Birmingham. I'm Peter Gow, and I'm part of the huge construction effort that's taking place here, and I'd like to tell you about the progress we're making on HS2's biggest station. Since our last update in 2023, we've moved into the new phase of construction. Now let's start underground, where we finished excavating a massive area. The platforms for HS2 trains will go inside this vast structure we're building. We call it the station box. The box is a feat of modern British engineering, 3 years in the making, such is the scale of HS2. It's about 65 feet deep, that's around 20 metres, and it's surrounded by a 1 mile wall made of reinforced concrete. We needed to clear 1.3 million tonnes of London clay from this box to create the space for HS2's platforms. This whole structure sits on a super strong base slab that's up to 13 feet thick that you can see behind me, which we'll be completing in the next 6 months. We've already started works on the HS2 platforms, and they're going to be finished in 2026. Each of those platforms will be 450 metres long, so they're comfortably handling HS2's trains, as they'll call here, and travel journeys north and south. When we're finished, there'll be 14 platforms, 6 for our high-speed services and 8 for regular services. Millions of passengers will use the station, including many of you watching this update, and I hope you're as excited as I am to experience that first journey on HS2. Above ground, there'll be 8 more platforms for the Elizabeth Line, the Great Western Main Line, and Heathrow Express services. And we've started works on the overground platforms, installing 1,200 supporting columns to hold the station superstructure. We've already started with building those platforms, precasting the slabs, and fabricating the steelwork that will be installed next year. We're doing everything we can to reduce our carbon emissions as we build HS2, and Old Oak Common is no different. With our use of minimal grid-supplied electricity and low carbon technologies, Old Oak Common will be net zero when we start running services. We'll even harvest rainwater from the roof to cover all of the flushing in the bathrooms. And our commitment to sustainable travel includes exceptional cycling facilities and charging points throughout the Old Oak Common site for electric vehicles. The design for public spaces has been inspired by local history and culture and includes features such as biodiverse meadow grassland, green walls, and roofs. During excavation of the station box, we used a special electric conveyor belt to take the spoil to our London logistics hub. Here, we put the waste material on trains and moved it to key sites across the country to be reused in new building projects. With the excavation of the station box now complete, we've decommissioned sections of the conveyor, though some parts will be used for the tunnelling into Euston. We're only using responsibly sourced steel, and most of our concrete is produced on-site, further cutting emissions from lorries. And our work reducing HS2's carbon footprint is paying off at Old Oak Common, with the station design placed in the top 1% of sustainable buildings worldwide. During the next phase of the project, we'll hand the east end of the station box to the team building the 4.5 mile Euston Tunnel, which will take HS2 into the heart of London. First, we'll need to lower 2 giant tunnel machines into the ground and prepare them for their journey under the capital. Then, we'll begin to put together the station superstructure and connect this vast HS2 underground station to the above ground station. We'll assemble the immense roof that will unite the 2 parts of the station together. That will cover an area the size of over 3 football pitches. We are working to help connect the station to the existing railway network, bringing the infrastructure into the station to enable Elizabeth Line, Great Western Main Line, and Heathrow Express services to stop here. This includes turning the current 4-track Great Western Main Line into an 8-platform arrangement, laying 28 kilometres of new track and installing new signalling, overhead lines, power and communication systems. The team have already been doing critical preparatory works, installing drainage, new signalling and preparing for large pieces of work in the coming years. Over Christmas this year, we'll be closing the stretch of the Great Western Main Line between Paddington and Ealing Broadway for critical works. We are working to ensure that passenger disruption is reduced, with some services being diverted into Euston on those days. Opening in the early 2030s, Old Oak Common will be a key stop on the new London to Birmingham line, putting passengers just 42 minutes from central Birmingham. We're planning to use Old Oak Common as HS2's temporary London terminus while we finish the route into Euston. And during this time, passengers will be able to use the Elizabeth line and get into central London in just 10 minutes. More than 2,000 people are working at Aldgate Common every day, building an exciting future in this former industrial area. We're using innovative building methods to create a thriving, well-connected neighbourhood, transforming the local area for future generations. The new station here is the linchpin of the ambitious Old Oak and Park Royal development, which is set to create 56,000 jobs and 25,000 homes in the area. We've taken great strides, but we've got plenty of work ahead of us. I look forward to updating you on our progress as Old Oak Commons station starts to rise from the ground.